everyone, and a very warm welcome to WS Cube Tech. So guys, in a previous session, we have covered that how with the help of beautiful soup and find all function, we have extracted the data along with the regular expressions. In our today's session, we will be using pandas to extract the data. So guys, again here we will be using beautiful soup and find all function, but the pandas, with the help of pandas, we will be creating a data frame here. And that data frame, you can store that data frame inside a CSV file or an Excel sheet as well. So let's have a look on how it can be done, and also before that, let's install the package for the pandas as well.
So it says pip install pandas. Let's copy this from here. Once we have copied this, let's go to our command prompt. I'll go to my command prompt, paste it over here. For me, it will say that requirement is already satisfied because I have already downloaded the package. For you, it will get downloaded. Once you have downloaded it, let's come back to our program. Here we will import. First of all, we'll start with importing requests. Then we will import pandas. I'll be creating an alias over here as pd and import, or actually we should be writing from bs4 import beautiful soup. So we have all three libraries over here. After this, we will be writing URL is equals to, because we need to get the URL of the page. Again, we will be using the same website that we have been using. So I'll just open it here and write. So I'll just open a new tab here and write web scrapping test sites. And not actually web, but web scrapping test sites. Let's open the first link. Once we have opened the first link, we can go to our e-commerce site. You can choose anything over here. So let's go for computers. So we have the data of three computers here. Let's go for something else. Maybe in tablets we have more data. Yes, in tablets we have 21 boxes. So I'll just copy this link from the top. Let's copy it. Let's go back to our program. Let's pass it in our URL. After this, we will be writing r is equals to requests dot get, and in this I'll be passing my URL. You can directly pass the URL in the get option, or you can create a variable of URL and then pass the link inside it. After this, we will be creating our soup. Soup is equals to beautiful soup. And here we will be writing r.text, and we'll handle the file in lxml. Once we are done with this, now what we need to get over here is that we need to get the products from every box here. So if I go back to my website, here let's right click and inspect it. Let's click on the navigation bar. Let's go for our first box here. In our first box, I'll just open it and open it even more. And more. So if you want, here we want different things. For example, if I want to obtain the name, price, description, and maybe reviews or the number of stars over here. In that case, all you need to do is go to the. So first of all, if I want to get the price over here, for price we have Lenovo Idea tab. Or sorry, first of all we need to get the name actually. So for name, we have the A tag which has a class title. Let's copy this from here. Let's go back to our program. And we will be writing soup. So first of all, over here, we will be creating a variable. You can write it as names or product names, whatever you like. And here we will be writing soup.find underscore all. And inside this, we will be passing our A tag, comma. We will be defining the class, that class underscore is equals to. In our double quotation, we will be passing the title, and we will print names. And if I run it, it will give me some data like this, that we have Lenovo Idea tab, then we have Idea tab, and then we have all-in-one Acer Iconia, right? So if I need to get this data inside a list, what I need to do is create an empty list. So I'll create a product underscore name. Product name is equals to an empty list. And now what I need to do is I need to use a for loop, that for I in names, that we will be creating a for loop. That means we will be iterating inside these values, inside the names. The names is the list over here. In these names, what we need to get is the product name. For product name, we will be writing I dot text. And we will be giving it a variable as well, that name is equals to, each name inside this list will be equal to i.text, and then this i.text will get appended to our product name. So we will be writing product name dot append I dot text, or instead we can write name as well. Lastly, let's try to print the product name list. So I'll print product name, and let's put this thing inside the comments. And as soon as I run it, this is how it looks like, that now we have Lenovo Idea Tab, and then Acer Iconia, Galaxy Tab, Iconia B1, 730 HD, and all the tablets are here. Okay, so this is how we have received the name of the tablet. Similarly, what we need to do over here is the same thing, that we need to get the prices here. For the prices, again, I'll write down prices is equals to, let's create some space for us. So prices is equals to the same thing we'll be doing over here, that means soup dot find all. So here also I'll be writing soup dot find all, and we will be passing the name of the tag. For that, let's move here, and here we have a price tag. For price tag, let's come here, and the price is in H4 tag, and the class says pull write price. So let's copy this H4 pull write price, H4 comma class underscore is equals to, inside the double quotation we will be writing pull write price. Same, we will be doing the same method over here. So I have written product, I don't know why, but it should be product name. Here also it should be product name. Here also it should be product name. Here we will be creating another list called as prices list. Okay, is equals to, this will again remain empty, and we will be using a for loop to iterate inside this list of prices and obtain the prices from here. So we will be using the similar method by writing for I in prices colon name is equals to I dot text, or you can write price is equals to i.text, whatever you want to write. So price is equals to i.text, and then inside our prices list we will append this price. And lastly, let's print prices as well, or actually prices list. Now let's run and see what output we'll get. So here we have the tablet, and also we have their prices. The next thing that we need to obtain from here is the description. For description, again, I'll do the same method, that here we will go for DESC is equals to soup dot find all. And here we will be again passing the name of the tag. For the name of the tag for description, we have P tag, and the class over here is description. So P tag and class underscore is equals to description, and I don't know, I must have written down something. So yeah, here we have the description, and again we will be treating here. So for I in description, and we need to also create a description list. For that, I'll be writing DESC underscore list is equals to an empty list here. So for I in description colon DES is equals to, or we can write anything over here, I dot text. And I'll again append it to our description list. So DESC underscore list dot append. What do we need to append with this description that we are getting in each iteration? So we'll be writing this description, and let's print it as well by writing print description list. And let's run and see what output we'll get again. So here we have the description as well. And lastly, the thing that we need over here is the reviews. For reviews, I'll just go back here, and let's try to understand that if we can obtain the stars or not. So for that, I'll be going here. Okay, so so data rating is 4-star. Data rating is equals to 4 here. And we have the reviews here. So we can get the reviews from here. For reviews, we have a class. So I'll just copy this. And not actually the reviews, but I need to copy the class. So I'll copy the class. Again, it's in P tag. So let's go back to our program. And reviews is equals to soup dot find all. Again, it's in our P tag, comma, class underscore is equals to, I'll pass the class here, that is pull write. And here we will be creating reviews list is equals to an empty list, and for I in reviews list, or actually reviews, we need to append inside the reviews list and not in the reviews. So here we will be treating in reviews, and here we will be writing REW is equals to I dot text, and then we will append it inside our list. So reviews list, and again I have written a wrong spelling, EW. Here also it should be EW dot append, and we will be appending REW here. Lastly, let's print it by writing print reviews list, and let's run it. So as soon as I run it, I'll get all my four data, that it has seven reviews, and we have the names, we have the, and here we will get all the data here, that is our names, product name, prices, the description, and the number of reviews. Once we are done with this, let's create a data frame out of it. For creating a data frame, I'll be writing, we have already imported the pandas module for that. Now for creating a data frame, we will be simply writing df is equals to pd dot data frame. Now for the data frame, what we need to provide is, the first thing is column name. The column name will be product name, and its value will be the product list. And I guess its name only is product name, I guess. We have prices list and we have product name, yes. So this is our product name list. And then we have the next key. That means the name of the next column over here would be prices. So prices, and inside the prices, the value would be prices list. Similarly, the next thing would be the description. And for description, we have description list. Lastly, we have number of reviews. And for that, we have reviews list. Let's print this data frame and see how the output looks like. Okay, so the data frame has been created here. Because of the lack of space, it is showing the triple dots. Let's try to add it inside an Excel file. For adding it inside an Excel file, all I'll do is write data frame dot to CSV. That means we will be converting into a CSV file. Now, if you're working on a different file, that means if your file is different, if your program file is different, and you want this file, the Excel file, to be saved in some other document or some other location, in that case, you need to provide a location. But if you want it to be created at the same location, in that case, you can simply write the name of the file. So, product details, I'll be writing product underscore details. Also, remember to write .csv in the end. And let's run and see. So I'll just put all these things inside the comments, so I do not have to print anything basically. I just have to convert these things into a data frame and then get it inside the Excel sheet. Here's the last one. And now let's run it. I hope it doesn't show any error. Yes, and as soon as I run it, there is no error. There are no errors. Let's go to the folder and see how does it looks like. And as soon as we open it, this is how our file looks like. So in our Excel, now we have the product names, we have the prices, we have the description, and also we have the number of reviews. So this is how you can obtain the data, and then you can store it in your Excel or CSV as well. For storing it in an Excel, we need to download another package that is called as pip install openpyExcel. So for that, all you need to do is write pip install openpyExcel, and as soon as you run it, this package will get installed, and after this you can store it in an Excel file as well by writing at the bottom that here what we are doing, we are converting it into a CSV. Instead of converting it to CSV, you can convert it to an Excel, and then you can change the name as well, and you can store it in the Excel file as well. So choice is totally up to you if you want to store it in an Excel file or in a CSV. So I hope guys that you have no doubts in the question and how we have created this program, how we have used pandas to create a data frame here, and then we have converted that data frame into a CSV file. In our next session, we are going to talk about how we can extract data from nested HTML tags. So stay connected guys, and I'll see you in the next session. Thank you.